I love knowing how things work. I love to take things apart and put things back together, and you know, if something breaks, I usually can't walk away from it until I figure out how to fix it.
When I was younger, I used to love bridges. I was interested in earthquakes and volcanoes and all this stuff. And I've just always had this interest in kind of the earth and how things are built.
When I was young, my dad pulled out a telescope and looked through the moon at it. When I noticed there was a chance to take it last summer, I went ahead and took one of the astronomy courses, fell in love with it, and been there ever since.
Our department encompasses physics, engineering, astronomy, and physical science. So in the physics, you get mechanics, you get electricity and magnetism, you get optics, you get quantum physics. In the engineering department, you get all the core engineering courses that they will need when they transfer to their four-year schools.
Engineering is an exciting field because you're always going to be looking into new things, and we can see it all around you, how things are changing, the design of a car. If you go to the hardware store, you will see the tools are also changing. So engineering is a dynamic field, so we can always find your little niche.
So we offer a diversity of courses that go from general astronomy, Astro 300, where we cover from planets to stars and galaxies. If you want more details in planetary sciences, we do solar system astronomy. And then if you want to look at the stars at night with telescopes, if you want to look into spectral emissions, we have a lab as well at night.
We have telescopes, which allows us to get very nice pictures of Jupiter, the Moon, Venus, Mars. Plus, the head professor, he's a practicing astrophysicist. So he brings his talent and his passion to the field. It's just kind of a pleasure to be here and have access to that.
In the engineering department, we teach the classes that are the lower division classes for students to get ready to transfer to universities. In the drafting class, I have them do sketching, so they're using freehand, and then we gradually go from just sketching to using instruments to using the computer.
The structure of the class is nice because rather than lecturing for a huge chunk of time, she breaks it up into pieces, and she breaks it up into very small steps so that you really understand everything.
She encourages students to ask questions. She won't go around and say, you know, look at it and be like, oh, do this. You'll be like, okay, what's wrong here? Can you explain to me what's wrong? Kind of prompt you to kind of think about the process, and then in a way, it kind of gets your brain going.
Talking is very important for me because I get to hear where they have problems. It's a means of thinking.
Yeah, it's gonna be a switch.
But it's kind of a hands-on process where I say play, but you know, we kind of do play. But there's equipment, they take data, they analyze the data, and then they compare the data to what should be expected theoretically.
So far I've learned about motion of objects, different vectors, and the basic concepts of calculating vectors and angles and, you know, projectiles. He has like a different projectile motion experiment for like every lecture. So, and it helps me pick up the material quicker to see it happen.
We have a lot of equipment, and as a department, we do make an effort to keep up to date with technology.
We also buy different samples to have them touching. As an example, this is a fossil of the oldest life form on Earth. We have extraterrestrial iron coming from meteorites. So this, you know, helps imagination if you touch something that came from outer space.
So most of the species on Earth were anaerobic. And whenever oxygen starts dissolving too much in the oceans, precipitates and forms this banded iron. So this is called a banded iron formation.
I'm currently active in Astronomy and Physics Club. As a mechanical engineering major / aerospace. What I really loved about physics was the chance to work with rockets, because I had never done before.
We have three very vibrant science clubs. There's the research club, the engineering club, and the physics and astronomy club. The research club has been working with 3D printers for a while now. The engineering club has entered into many competitions. They actually built a 3D printer. The physics and astronomy club, they launched a balloon into near space about 22 miles up. And they took some images, some video images of the Earth from that altitude.
We also have access to the radio antennas of the NASA deep space stations in Goldstone. We cannot have a 32 meters gigantic antenna in our backyard, but we have a protocol with NASA and Goldstone Apple Valley telescopes. We can operate them here from the computers. And so students can steer these gigantic telescopes and look for the magnetosphere of Jupiter as an example, or radio emissions in quasars, or even look for extraterrestrial life.
In the first astronomy class I took, it really opened my eyes to what I was capable of. Actually, I never thought that I would ever go down this route. I was really just trying to get my associate's degree. Didn't think I could do much more. Now I'm looking at getting a doctorate and going on to higher education and something that I never thought of.
This is my last semester before I transferred to university. At first, it was scary. All these new topics and new language that you don't know, but because they're great professors and really approachable on the topics, I'm able to, you know, ask them questions in class and you get the hang of it eventually.
Coming to AR, it makes you feel at home. And the teachers help, and the rest of the staff helps, the counselors help. It just reminded me that if I start here and I'm really determined, I can do whatever I want to do.